Hey guys, welcome back to one of our Tier 1 therapy team videos. Myself, Ollie and Stuart here today.
Hey guys.
We're talking about the hamstrings and how they are so powerful. And John, of course, our beautiful model. We're talking about the hamstrings and how they are so strong, powerful now, and how we use them. So, over to you, Stu.
Yeah, okay. So, last week we talked about the glutes, and particularly the glute bridge, and we love the glutes here. We've got nothing against the glutes. But the hamstrings are way more powerful in terms of how they affect the pelvis, how they can affect the lower back, how they can affect your core and everything like that, okay? I've read so many books, so many articles about like how important it is to have good glutes in terms of pelvic tilt and pelvic control and stuff like that, when actually they're missing the hamstrings. The glutes, okay, the glute max and everything like that, they actually attach onto the hip. The hamstrings actually attach onto the pelvis from below. So with regards to that, they have a very, very profound effect on pelvic stability and pelvic control, okay, and how we deal with gravity and interact with the ground. With the hamstrings, they act like reins, okay, so if they attach down here, they can specifically pull the pelvis into a desired position and we can control it from there, okay. We talk about hold control and stuff like that. Literally, if you have your hamstrings, you can hold your pelvis in position like that on the left side. If you have your right hamstring, you can control your pelvis on the other side. The glutes cannot do that, okay? So it's really important you get that concept. Somebody's in that sort of extended posture, they're stuck there. If we can get the hamstrings to act like reins and pull down, we either can then regain control of our pelvis, we can regain control of our abs, and then we're cooking with gas. So how do we get our hamstrings, Ollie? It's in one. We use the 90-90, don't we? So we love a little ball, okay?
A pair of balls.
We love a ball. Remember your one ball. Okay, so with the ball, goes into the knee, okay, in between the knees. John, I want you to just have a little squeeze there. We call this the 90-90 position because you have a 90-degree angle here and roughly a 90-degree angle here, okay? So whenever you hear us say 90-90, it's this position here. It makes the hips all nice and loosey-goosey. It's a great position to get your hamstrings going, okay? So, we have toes up, that's important, toes to the sky. John, I'm gonna ask you to vertically press down into the box with your heels, okay? Press down vertically, off you go, okay? And all of a sudden, what do we feel? Hamstrings come on.
Hamstrings,
now,
yeah.
If we pop that pelvis on there, let go of that for me, John. If someone's in an anterior tilt pelvis, extended posture, if we then get him, toes up, push down, okay? All of a sudden, we've got control of the pelvis, back switched off, and we're cooking with gas. So, on there, John, what I want you to do, this is how we coach it up to get hamstrings. Just relax for me. Relax, okay? Nice and jelly belly. Okay? Heels down. Heels down, okay? Get your hamstrings on. Heels down, and in that position, relax through here, and just bring your knees up into my hand by pushing vertically down with your heels. Up you go. Up you go. Guess what he's got? He's got his hamstrings. He's got a posterior pelvic tilt. His lower back is switched off. Obviously, he's nice and jelly belly here. Now what I want you to do, John, just have a little reach for me. Reach up. The reach is really important because that helps the rib cage come down. And now we're ready to go. So inhale through your nose, just like the glute bridge. Exhale out of your mouth. Get those abs on. Little reach. Heels vertically down. Toes up. Okay? Inhale. Exhale, squeeze, okay? Down, what do you feel, John?
Hamstrings, baby.
There you go. Okay, inhale, exhale, heels down, knees up, squeeze. Now we've got hamstrings, now we've got pelvic control.
And a hamstring crap.
And now we've got abs, okay? Perfect. There you go.
What's exercise do? When do you feel like you'd use this in sort of rehab and in training and stuff?
Okay, so we use it pretty much at the very beginning of our training or rehab programs because by doing this, we actually achieve a really profound effect called repositioning. So we've repositioned the pelvis back underneath him. We've got stability. We've got his hamstrings. We've got his abs. Okay, so we've repositioned the body. We've just restored global movement, okay? We've repositioned his shoulders, we've repositioned his hips, we've got his hamstrings going, we've got his core, okay? His body is in the perfect position now to basically ramp up and go through a warm-up or go through some rehab or start to train.
So is there any person that this wouldn't help? Or is it, could anyone do this exercise and get good results?
Why wouldn't it help anybody? Okay, his back's nice and stable on the floor, so if you've got a back pain patient, you're in a decent position, okay? Your hips are nice and loose, your shoulders are okay, obviously we're in the perfect position to go.
What about a pulled hamstring?
Anyone can do it, yeah.
What about a pulled hamstring?
Got a pulled hamstring.
You've got a pulled hamstring, and obviously once you've let the initial injury settle, it's perfect because it's an isometric exercise, really, and you're sharing the load 50-50, okay? So any early intervention hamstring program, it's perfect, okay? Okay. Cool. What happens to most hamstring problems? Why do they stretch? Yeah, that anterior tilt of the pelvis places the hamstrings on length, hamstrings attach here, tip forward, you're increasing the distance or the length of the hamstrings, that hamstring is now tight, okay, and potentially at risk. This exercise restores the pelvis, gets your hamstrings actually, believe it or not, in an unlengthened state, so it actually neutralizes the hamstrings.
Okay, there guys, so there you have it. The hamstrings and why they're so important and why we love them here at Tier 1. Tune in next week for another episode, and don't forget to like us on Facebook and YouTube. Cheers, guys.